as a provider that specializes in hormone therapy, I know that it's a huge quality of life issue. Weight gain, libido issue, even depression and anxiety. Hair loss is really a huge symptom, both in men and women. Unfortunately, a lot of the times, people are blown off. Told that, it's just, your age, you're getting older, or, making some other excuse. You're not getting enough sleep, you're too busy. It's your lifestyle, it's your diet, it's what you're eating. Well, you need to find a provider who does specialize in the hormones and who's comfortable checking the hormones and actually developing a treatment plan regarding hormone optimization. Go ahead and check the hormones for the patient and find the root cause of why they're having these hormonal imbalances. That doesn't always have to include hormone replacement therapy. If you Google the term endocrine disruptor, what you'll find is the National Institutes of Health. So the NIH website will come up. If you Google this, you will see a whole list of endocrine disruptors. It'll blow your mind because it's things that we are exposed to on a daily basis. Body wash, plastic bottles, pesticides, things in our food, things in our soil, deodorant, cosmetics, you name it, just these everyday things that we're exposed to that you would never think, oh my gosh, the mascara that I'm putting on could be messing up my hormone. That was something that I had to go to school and get additional training for. It's not really something that's touched on very much in, traditional primary care training. But now we're actually seeing these hormone issues pop up, starting around early 30s, age 35 to 45. So with that being said, if you find a provider who's comfortable with checking your hormones and coming up with different various treatment modalities to help correct those issues, you're going to be in a much better position to start improving your quality of life. It's actually your longevity and your ability to live a long, healthy life. That's how important these hormones are. But it could also be things like developing chronic conditions in the future. So like, for example, women who deal with lack of estrogen, they have a higher lifetime prevalence of developing medical conditions such as osteoporosis. You have a much higher probability of developing obesity if your hormones are imbalanced. And we all know obesity can lead to just a slew of challenges, your blood pressure issues, diabetes, etc. Once you do identify and correct the root cause or causes, because a lot of times it is multifactorial, you can just make a huge impact on that person's quality of life, but also just their long-term health in general.